Ski jumping is her passion. So she chose to live in Innsbruck to be close to the famous jumper easel. In fact, she can see the hill from her flat. Her name is Daniela Iraschko, an Austrian dedicated to ski jumping and ski flying, which she tasted for the first time as a young girl, and she's never ceased to feel the thrill.
I think a ski jumper is not an ordinary person. To do this sport, you really need to be a special person.
But everyone who's jumped once, well, I believe they just can't walk away from it. And they'll say to themselves, their whole life through, yes, it was right to do it. Daniela Iraschko has reached the peak of her sport. She became world champion in Oslo in 2011. She's won World Cups and 45 victories in the Continental Cup. But making her way as a female ski jumper hasn't been easy. Way back, the ski jumpers were all guys. I wanted to do the same, but wasn't allowed to jump. But I kept up the pressure until I was allowed to try ski jumping. And then, suddenly, everyone agreed that I could continue with the sport. So I guess it wasn't all bad, was it? Daniela discovered her sport at the tender age of 11. At that time, female ski jumping simply didn't exist. She had to fight to be able to join the boys in training and competition. But the young Austrian was determined that one day she would get the recognition that she wanted. Finally, I've grown into it quite easily. The sport didn't exist for women, and that was completely understandable, but I've always succeeded in everything I wanted to achieve, and I always wanted to jump as far as possible. I was always accepted by the guys as a college student, too, and as a friend. In 2003, Daniela really made her mark. She was the first woman to fly over 200 meters during practice for a World Cup event at the Kulm. 2 years later, in 2005, she took part in her first Winter University Games at Innsbruck, the first time women would take part. It was organized as a huge event, the first Universiade, which all the media really took an interest in. And it was also the year where I'd finished school and got straight into studying. So I was able to take part, and when I won, the atmosphere was indescribable. In front of her home crowd, Iraschko had to deal with the pressure. On the Seefeld Hill near Innsbruck, she was the favorite. I can remember that I jumped badly in practice, and I'd lost my nerve. I was so frustrated because I was so bad. I couldn't handle that hill, even though it was my own ski jump hill. And I never liked that hill at Seefeld, really, that hill. But Iraschko didn't want to disappoint her local fans. In the practice round, I was only fourth or fifth or sixth or even worse. So I thought, everybody's looking at you. It was so exciting, that first jump, and I flew so far. Even today, I don't know how I managed to do it. It'll always be a mystery for me, how I could jump so far on that hill. 98.5 meters in the first jump. Iraschko's determination, combined with prodigious talent, put her in the lead. A surprise, even for her. I think I succeeded because of my frustration. It was incredible. I said to myself, you have to do it now. And I did it. Suddenly, all my negative thoughts disappeared. It really was a risky moment. Athletes are often in this kind of situation. But to be able to achieve it is not something that happens too often. And I said to myself, you've got to take all the risks, because when you don't take risks, you simply can't win. I realized very clearly at that moment what I had to do. The student of education would compete again in 2007 at the Winter University Games in Turin, adding another gold to her collection. For Daniela, the University Games victories symbolize the highest recognition as an athlete and a student.
diese Doppelbelastung, also
I know what a double load means, how difficult it is to combine studying and practice sport at a high level. You don't really have time, you have to sacrifice your life. You have nothing when you're studying, and if you don't complete your studies and you're only an athlete, you still have nothing. So you have a hard life without money, and therefore the achievement of winning the Universiade title is very important. The Austrian is still recovering from a serious knee injury she picked up in a fall last January at Hintersatten. It meant the end of her 2012-2013 season. But Iraschko is still thinking positively as she looks ahead to the upcoming Winter Olympics in Sochi. The fact that I'm not actually jumping, I'm not able to do it, has allowed me to practice in a different way for several months to enable me to get back into competition as quickly as possible. With her victory in Sochi last year in the World Cup, Daniela knows she could become the first Olympic champion in the history of women's ski jumping. She's been a real pioneer, and the journey for her is not yet over. The drive is always there. I'm constantly trying to push the boundaries in women's ski jumping. Of course, sometimes it doesn't happen as quickly as I'd like, but the direction is okay. The path is the aim. I know that I won't experience everything in my career, but I know that I've done a lot for women's ski jumping, and that makes me very proud. Daniela Iraschko still has a lot to give. Let's hope she's completely fit for the challenge of Sochi.